Hello everybody and welcome back to Let's Play Xanadu for the MSX. In the meantime I've run around outside here a little bit, killed a couple of monsters just to get our golden experience up a little bit. But now I think we're just about ready to start taking on this tower. You know what, maybe just one or two more of these guys. As you can see, these guys have a deck magic attack, but our magic resistance is so high that it doesn't hurt us, so they can basically shoot us all they like and it won't really hurt us. Now I'm just checking to see, this is either food or a red potion. These are the red potion ones, so let's just take them out like this. A red potion heals a lot more than 10,000 hit points by now, so yeah, worth the investment. Okay, so yeah, let's just get started with this small tower. There's a couple of reasons I wanted to show you this one. And that's because there's a couple new things that happen in this one that we haven't seen before. And it has a couple of items that are very much worth chasing after. As you can see, these lampreys drop food, so not too important. Now here's one of the things you haven't seen before, which is if we move into this room, it is a one-way exit. You cannot go back. This will start happening a lot more in the coming towers, but this is the first time we'll see it. Sometimes it's combined with teleporting you as well, so it can be extremely confusing in later levels. For now it's okay. These lampreys I think drop a black onyx, so that's going to be worth it. Yeah. Oh yeah, and here's the second thing we really want from this tower, which is the silver pendant, which will raise our intelligence by 10. We have 75 right now, and now we have 85. It does cost us a key, but yeah, of course stat-ups. Trading a key for a stat-up is a no-brainer. These bloodworms drop a candle, so let's just shoot them. No need to risk any health for these guys. Of course it costs us a second key as well, because we also have to get out of this room, but again, any sort of stat up is worth almost any amount of keys in my opinion. Okay, these guys drop gold if I'm... yeah, I'm pretty sure. So we can just magic these guys away as well. Now I'm hoping after we finish this tower and maybe a couple more monsters outside that we will have enough gold to get ourselves a stronger deck spell. Because our single target magic spell now is extremely powerful. The tilt is the second most powerful spell in the game. But there are going to be cases, especially in the following few levels, where we are going to want to be able to kill all the monsters in a stack extremely quickly. Again, level 7, 6, I'm sorry, yeah, 6 is where we are. Level 6, not the most powerful creatures compared to level 5, so we'll be okay here. We're getting pretty close already, I think we need 90 something thousand. Okay, and this is the second item we really want from this tower, which is the purple boots, and they raise our dexterity. We're at 75 now, 85, so very nice. And that's it, this is really a very, very small tower, so yeah, pretty quick, but absolutely worth it. Losing four keys in the process is a little bit annoying, of course, but for plus 10 to dexterity as well as intelligence, and picking up some random nice items and a fairly nice stack of gold, that's going to be enough compensation. Reason I just went in and out again is to make sure our save game is up to date. Okay, so kind of a short video. Maybe I'll show a couple more monster fights, just so it's not so short. After this I will be trying to clear out as many monsters as I can, like I'm doing right now, and from there on we will yeah, we're also getting ready for the big tower, because that's the only other tower in this level. There's just a small one and one really big one. The reason why it's so big is because that's the way towers work. Each level has a fixed number of rooms for towers. I forget how many exactly. But let's say, for example, there's 24 rooms total in each level. That means that if there's two towers and one of them has four rooms, then the other one will have 20 automatically. Now, it might be true that some levels don't use all the rooms. I'm not really sure about that. I'd have to look it up. But broadly speaking, if there's one really tiny tower, then the other one is effectively going to be very big. Do I need to? Oh yeah, these are weak anyway. I'll just stab them. I think it's a spectacle. Yeah. Normally, spectacle's not really worth taking damage for, but these guys are pretty weak, so it's not that big a deal. Some more owlbears. These are very strong, so I am going to. I think these guys drop a magic glove. Is that worth taking 20,000 damage or so? I don't think so. Magic gloves are so common in towers anyway that I don't think they're worth getting hurt over. Some more Creator sources. These are probably the candle type, I'm guessing. This we'll see in a second. So as you can see, fight's slightly more challenging than in the previous level, but not that much. Now starting from level 7, the next one, that's going to change. Monsters are definitely going to rise in power significantly there. I'm sort of hoping we might be able to pick up some magic armor in this level, but I'm not really sure. These are food, right? Oh no, they're not. Oh no, these are poison, I remember. There's a reason why I didn't want to use my melee attacks on them, and the reason is they are monsters that drop poison when you kill them. There we go, get them out of the way. The second, third, and fourth spawns of the Ascomoids are worth it because they drop keys, if I'm not mistaken. And of course, as I like to say, keys are extremely important in this game. There's a bunch of dead ends, and the reason for that is that there's a lot of places where you can fall down, and then they make you go down this passage. Oh, down this little ladder is the... Oh, I can probably show you. Is the healer, as well as a food shop and an inn. So yeah, this is the place to go if you're short on any of those. As you can see, that's the only way in. And to get out, we have to drop down this hole again. I think I'll stock up on a little bit more food in the meantime. I know I always keep my food a little bit high, but that's just because I've gotten stuck before without enough food, and it's just a really annoying way to die. So I like to make sure my food is more than enough to last me for the coming time. Especially because it's pretty cheap, so it doesn't really matter. Like I said, this is the second I think it's the second spawn of these Ascomoids, so we are going to try and get their item. Because I believe it's a key or something similarly valuable. Since they don't directly attack us, they're pretty easy to kill anyway. Oh, it's a balance, okay. That was kind of useless, but oh well, it didn't cost us very much. I think the next spawn is probably the key spawn then. And these, as you can see, are very aggressive. They are coming straight for us. They're coming right for us! South Park, which you probably know. Except the difference here is that we aren't shooting cute, harmless little bunnies here. We are shooting giant eyeball monsters that want to kill us. Oh, for frick's sake. I was just talking about how much I wanted to get his key, and then I shoot him. It's so hard to pay attention while talking. And oh, I think this is the final spawn, so this one should also have a key, I think. And this time I'm going to try to actually remember to... kill it properly. And in fact, I think after this one I'll probably cut off the video, because I'm not 100% sure, but I think we're likely coming up on our time limit. Yeah, let's just kill this one and then we'll end it. And there we have our key. Okay guys, thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next part.